ओके तो लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द जनरल फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ एन लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग प्रॉब्लम. इन द लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड दैट देयर आर बेसिकली थ्री थिंग्स दैट यू नीड टू टेक केयर व्हेन वी आर गोइंग फॉर अ फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ एन एलपीपी. सो व्हाट इज अ फॉर्मुलेशन? फॉर्मुलेशन मींस व्हेन वी आर कन्वर्टिंग the verbal communication into mathematical equations. So three things that you need to take care is, first one is called the decision variables. So depending upon the verbal communication, you have to identify those factors which will be affecting your decision. So those factors which affect your decision are known as decision variables. These variables are there can be n variables. These n variables will be represented by x1, x2, x3 and xn. Now I am using x1, x2, x3, xn. You can use any other terminology, but the essence is that there will be some number of variables which are affecting your final decision. So first thing is you need to identify those decision variables. Once your decision variables are identified, you need to find out constraints or the limitations. These constraints are given by a11 x1 plus a12 x2 plus a13 x3 to a1n xn. All these will have some weightage in a particular constraint. So this is my first constraint, constraint number one. So in this constraint number one, this constraint can be of three types. First constraint can be of three types. One is called less than or equal to. Less than or equal to means it should not be greater than, not greater than. Okay, correct. If this is equal to means exactly equal to, or can be of the order greater than equal to, at least this value. Okay, minimum of this value. So it should be maximum value. This is equal value, and this is minimum value. Okay. So constraints can be of these three different types. Any doubts in this? Anyone having any doubt in this? Okay. So if this is constraint for n variables, then there can be m number of constraints. M number of constraints means one constraint on say material, one constraint on man, or man hours, one constraint on energy, some constraint on power or electrical power, okay, or some constraint can be on your money. So there can be various constraints. These constraints are M constraints. So you will get a matrix of M by N. So M number of rows depending upon the constraints and N number of columns depending upon the number of variables. What we have here is the value constraint or value of the constraint. So this is B, your B vector. Okay. Anyhow, after identifying the constraints, then we need to have the objective function defined. So what you see here is an objective function. Now, objective function is also of two types. One is the maximization and the other one is minimization. We already discussed this, that maximization will be profits. So I'm just writing for the sake of remembrance that it will be profit or it can be the cost. So cost can be minimization. So either of the two. So both of the, when we are not sure whether it is maximization or minimization, we write the word optimized. whatever it may be, either it may be maximization or minimization, we are going to optimize it. Optimize means, what is an optimum value? Optimum value indicates that this is the best suited value, which satisfies all the constraints and is also giving you the maximum or minimum value of the objective function that you desire. That you desire, that is most important. We need to identify whether it is the maximization or whether it is the minimization. So that is your desire. You need to make sure that your objective function is defined properly. And then the most important thing is non-negativity constraint. Non-negativity constraint means you cannot have the man hours in constraint, isn't it? You cannot say that this person will work for minus 5 hours. Will it be possible? No, not possible. You don't have the money that I'll have the money in minus 500. Is it possible? No. You can lend the money, but that value cannot be negative for a particular constraint. We have to make sure that all the values are in positive numbers. So that is why we have a non-negative constraint. It will be more clear if we take one problem. Okay. So let me just open one problem for you. Just one second. So what I'll do is I'll just okay, I think now you people will be able to share, see my screen. Is it visible? Somebody please respond. Students, please respond.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you can see one example of LP model formulation. In this section, we a number of illustrations, we don't want to read this. We'll just go to example 2.8.1, example on production. That is example 2.1. A manufacturing company is engaged in producing 3 types of products. So what manufacturing company is doing? They are manufacturing 3 types of products. So let me just write the given data first. So for that, I'll be writing solution number 2.8.1. This is from J.K. Sharma. Operations research by J.K. Sharma. You can refer any book, but and mostly I'll be referring to this book only. But anyhow, if you go for operation research, basically you need to understand these steps. Any book you can follow. Okay. Anyhow, let us go to the problem. So a manufacturing firm has 3 products. So first and foremost, I need to understand what are my decision variables. So first thing I know is there are products being manufactured by the company. So products are A, B, and C. Okay. Now, the production department produces each day components sufficient to make 50 units of A, 25 units of B, and 30 units of C. So the components that are produced can produce 50 units of A, 25 units of B, and 30 units of C. Okay. The management is confronted. Just one second, students. Okay. So the management is confronted with the problem of optimizing the daily production of the product in the assembly department where 100 man hours are available. So what we know that the limitation is, limitation is 100 man hours. Okay, so we know that the 100 man hours will be required or is available for assembly of the product. The following additional information is available. So what we know that the additional information is given. So what is the additional information? Okay. So what we know here is, sorry. So what we know here is that the depending upon the type of product, let me just draw one table. So we have table, say products, so let me write it here only. I'll remove this limitation. I'll just write here, that was units, now profit. So we have profit as 12, 20 and 45. And here we know that assembly time is given as 0.8 hours, 1.7 hours, 2.5 hours. And we know that this total should be less than 100 hours. Should be less than equal to 100 hours. That was given in here. That the total, if I go somewhere here. See, here, in this line, if you read, the management is confronted with the problem of optimizing the daily production of the products in the assembly department, where only 100 man hours are available. So it is clearly mentioned that the man hours are only 100. So we have to be very sure that the total assembly time should not increase 100 man hours per day. Okay, 100 man hours per day means you do not have an day of more than 24 hours. How you are managing that 100 hours is that total number of manpower working for 8 hour shift will reach to 100 hours if the number of people are more. Okay, there should be number of people. Okay, now the company has a daily order commitment of, now there is a daily order commitment. Here also we have a daily order commitment. Daily order commitment is how much is there for 20 units for A and a total of 15 units for B and C. So including both, we have to prepare 15 units. Okay. Now, formulate the problem as an LP model so as to maximize total profit. So now here they have clearly mentioned that you have to maximize profit. So this makes this column as your objective function. Okay. So I have identified the objective function, and this objective function is of what order? It is of the order of maximization. So you have to maximize profit. So let us say my decision variables, I am going to decide my decision variables as the number of products manufactured for A, number of products manufactured for B, and number of products manufactured for C. So X1 is the number of product A. X2 is number of product B. Number of product B, and X3 is number of product C. Okay, so total profit, if I write now total profit, can I write total profit? So I can write maximize, I'll be writing my objective function, maximize Z, that is my profit, or you can write profit, maximize profit. Maximize profit equal to, what is profit? 12 x1. How 12 x1? Per unit it is 12 rupees profit. So number of units is x1 for A plus 20 into x2 plus 45 into x3. Correct? This is my objective function. Subjected to constraints. Subjected to constraints. First constraint, this is on the assembly line. So we know it very well. We can easily write it. So let me write the first constraint as 0.8 x1 plus 1.7 x2 plus 2.5 x3 should be less than equal to 100. Correct? This is our 0.8 hours it requires to assemble one product of A. So 0.8 into x1 will be the number of products manufactured for A, will give you the total assembly time of A. Total assembly time of B will be 1.7 into x2. Total assembly time of C will be 2.5 into x3. So total assembly time in a day should not exceed 100 man hours. Correct? So this is my first constraint. What about the second constraint? I know that x1 should always be greater than equal to 20. How do I get this? This was given in the second last line. The company has a daily order commitment for 20 units for product A. So this we know that should be greater than equal to 20. At the same time, we also know that x1, x2 plus x3 should always be greater than equal to 15. That is, your daily order commitment for B and C is 15. See, here it is written, a total of 15 units of product B and C. Okay, so total means that is summation. Okay, then what about this last part? This is that they are able to produce a maximum of x1 should be less than equal to 50 units, because the components, this is your man hour constraint. Correct? This is your daily commitment constraint. Daily commitment constraint. And what is this? This is my material constraint. How I am saying that this is my material constraint? Because if you read the first line, what they have said, that a manufacturing company is engaged in producing three types of product A, B, and C. The production department produces each day components. That is, the components required to manufacture product A is sufficient to make only 50 units of A, 25 units of B, and 30 units of C. That means X1 should always be less than equal to 50, X2 should always be less than equal to 20, and X3 should always be less than equal to 30. Correct? This is all, sorry, this is not 20, this is 25, my mistake here. So it's going to be 25, and this is 30. So these all three are material constraints. Okay, so if I write my problem now, I have already defined my objective function. See, here my objective function is defined. So the solution will be, now this is my solution, final answer. Final answer is maximize Z that is equal to 12x1 plus 20x2 plus 45x3. Subjected to first I'll write the man hour constraint. So it is 0.8 x1 plus 1.7 x2 plus 2.5 x3 should be less than equal to 100. Similarly, then I'll write the daily commitment constraint, that is x1 should be greater than equal to 20, x2 plus x3 should be greater than equal to 15. Then x1 should be less than equal to 50, x2 should be less than equal to 25 and x3 should be less than equal to 30. These are my constraints. After writing this constraint, so how many constraints we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 constraints. So here my n is equal to 3 depending upon the number of products, and m is equal to 6. 6, na? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So my matrix will be 6 by 3. You can draw the matrix later. That is not required now. But most important thing that we are not written here. If I write up to this point, I'll get 50% or say 70% of the marks. But I'll not get the full marks. Why? Because I have missed the most important constraint, that is x1, comma x2, comma x3, all should be greater than equal to 0. This is called a negativity constraint. Okay, why this is important? Because the products cannot be manufactured negatively. I cannot have minus 5A products. I cannot have minus 1B products, or I cannot have minus 1C products. So all of them should have either 0. Either what it means is I'm not going to produce product A, or I'm not going to produce product B, or I'm not going to produce product C. That I can do, but I cannot ensure that all the products are
negative.
Sorry, my mistake. Okay, so is it clear now? Any doubts, students here? Any doubt, students? Students, any doubts? Up to this point, anybody is having any doubt? Hello? Yes, please ask your question. Anyone having any doubt in this? Sorry. Praveen 330, please join by your roll number. Please name yourself by your roll number. Anyone having any doubt, please ask me now. We have got only 7 minutes left. So I'm trying to finish one more question, if possible. Okay, so we'll quickly go through question number 2. So a belt manufacturer produces 2 types of belts. And the material required for each belt in kgs is given in the table. Okay, so the table is product, or let me just write it, belt. My mistake. Sometimes this pad creates a lot of problems, though it helps in writing, but sometimes it is problematic. Okay, let us go back. So belt may be A, B. Here we have material as leather. Leather is in kg, so 50 kgs. This is 30 kgs. And then we have hooks. This is 10 kg, this is 12 kg. Then we have stripes, or what you call it as gum, as 5 kgs. This is 3 kgs. Okay. And then we also have one column for profit. Profit is 5 rupees per belt, and this is 3 rupees per belt. Profit in rupees. Okay. Now, in this is one table, and then they have written the total product manufactured in a day is 170 pieces. The belt A requires 1 kg of leather, 1 hook, and 0.5 strips. The belt B requires 2 kg of leather, 1 hook, and 1 stripe. Formulate LPP. So now here we have to define the LPP. So first is solution. We know that the profit is to be maximized. So let us write maximize profit. Now for that we need decision variables. So let me write here decision variables. I'll be using decision variables as X1 and X2. So I'll be writing profit Z is equal to 5 into X1 plus 3 into X2. Okay. Now, subjected to constraint means A requires 1 kg of leather. So X1 should be less than equal to 50. Because 1 kg. But 2x2 should be less than equal to 30. How I have reached to 2x2? 2 kgs per belt. So 2 into x2 number of belts should be less than equal to 30. This is leather constraint. Similarly for hook, x1 should be less than equal to 10. So comma x2 should be less than equal to 12. Both have one hook. Similarly, stripes, 0.5 x1 should be less than equal to 5, and x2 should be less than equal to 3. So these are my constraints. Other than this, there is one more constraint, which is total pieces. Total pieces, that is x1 plus x2 should be less than equal to 170. Okay, so this is my problem. Any doubts in this? Sometimes they may give you a confusing table like this.